day. My name is John Milroy Fernandez, lecturer at Department of Interior Design and Decoration, Milagres College, Mangalore. So here we'll discuss, about the projection of a solid, the basic concepts to be followed while solving any of the problems. So there are the first step. So we have certain steps to be followed. That is the first step, the true shape of the base to be drawn. The next, after you draw the true shape of the base, the next step is to draw the true shape of the solid. So the third step, that is the tilted solid. And in the fourth step, we either get the top view or the front view. And in the fifth step, either with the help of the normal plane method, the general plane method, or the auxiliary inclined plane method, we are going to get one more view. So these are the steps to be followed while solving any of the problems. The first thing is to know which is the type of the base it is, the true shape of the base to be drawn. If it is a pyramid, so which is the type of the pyramid it is, which type of pyramid it is, maybe it is a square pyramid. So if it is in a square pyramid, the square base to be drawn. If it is a pentagonal pyramid, the pentagonal base to be drawn. So like that, the next step, that is the after you draw the base, the true shape of the base is being drawn, the next step is to draw the true shape of the solid, where you have to look at the height of the solid and then draw the true shape of the solid. In the next step, the true shape of the solid is being tilted. So that is the third step. And in the fourth step, either you get the front view or the top view. So that is depend on the question what you receive in your examination. And in the fifth step, that is the I've marked it as auxiliary inclined plane. So the fifth view, that in the fifth step, the whatever the view you get, so that can be obtained through a normal plane method or the auxiliary inclined plane method also. Okay, so next, when coming to the pyramid, so the first thing is to know how to draw the base in a pyramid. So here I have two square pyramids, two pentagonal pyramid, two hexagonal base been drawn. So these are all the base of pyramid. So the first one, the square pyramid which is drawn. So when it comes to the square pyramid, so both are the square pyramid. The first one is also a square pyramid. The second one is also a square pyramid. So here, if you look at the first diagram, so when you get a question that a square pyramid of so and so is resting on HP or resting on VP, so either the question it is, so which is the square pyramid to be drawn, so which kind of base to be drawn, so in either the first one or the second one, so out of these, which is the base to be chosen? So we can either choose the first one, the ABCD, so where the edge is being placed at the right side, and here if you look at the second diagram, the second square pyramid, the base of the second square pyramid, so that is being drawn. So how can I tell it is a base of the pyramid? So since all the points have been joined to a single point here at the center, so in both the figures, the all the points have been joined to the single point at the center, that is which is marked with the OP. Here, even in the second diagram also, it is all the points have been joined to the single point, that is OP. So O is where we have the apex or vertex we call as. So how to decide which is the square pyramid to be drawn, either the first one or the second one? So this is very important. So when in your question you get that the edge of base, the square pyramid of edge of base is in HP. So square pyramid of edge of the pentagonal pyramid of edge of base is in HP. So next, if you look at the hexagonal pyramid of edge of base is in HP. So in such case, the edge, so here I have marked with the red color lines. So that is the edge. So here also in the pentagonal pyramid, I have marked the edge. In the hexagonal pyramid also, you can look at the edge where I have marked it. So here, if at all in your question you get, if you find that if it is said that the square pyramid or the pentagonal pyramid or the hexagonal pyramid is resting on the edge of base, the square pyramid of edge of base is resting on HP. So in that condition, the edge to be kept at the right side. So always remember that. So whatever is to be kept on HP or VP, that is to be kept on the right side. So here, if you look at all the three important type of square pyramids, so that is the I've already said y'all that these three types are very important. That is the square pyramid, the pentagonal pyramid, and the hexagonal pyramid. So if you look at all the three diagrams, so in the first, that is the square pyramid. In the second, it is a pentagonal pyramid, and in the last one, the third one, that is the hexagonal pyramid. So how can I call it as a hexagonal pyramid? So all the points. So if you look at the hexagonal side, hexagonal shape here, A, B, C, D, E, F. So all the six points have been joined to the single point, that is O and P. Okay. So here, if you look at all the three diagram, the edge is being placed at the right side. So if at all in your question it is given that the edge, the square, the pentagonal pyramid or the square pyramid or the hexagonal pyramid of edge of base is on HP or VP, then the edge is to be kept at the right side. So if you look at all the three diagrams, it is the edge of base that is kept in the right side. So next, so if at all in your question it is given that the corner of the square pyramid or the pentagonal pyramid or the hexagonal pyramid has the corner kept in the corner is in HP or VP. So then at that time, the corner to be kept at the right side. So whichever is to be kept on HP or VP, that is to be kept at the right side. Okay, so here also, next in one more condition where this kind, the first square pyramid to be drawn. So if it is said that the slant face or the triangular face, so how does the triangular face or the slant face is being formed? So triangular face or the slant face is being formed by joining two points from the base and one point of the apex. So this is how it looks from the top. So if you look at the square pyramid or the pentagonal pyramid or the hexagonal pyramid from the top, it will look like this. You have the slant edges as well. So all these OD, OA, OB, OC are the slant edges, and these OCD and ODA and OBA, OBC. So all these are the triangular face or the slant face we call it as. So if it is given that the triangular face or the slant face is in HP or VP, then the first square pyramid or the first pentagonal pyramid or the first hexagonal pyramid to be drawn. So if it is given in the question that the triangular face is in HP or VP, the first pyramid to be drawn. So when it comes to the second one here, where I've given the slant edge. So here, if it in your question it is given that the slant edge is on HP, the slant edge is on VP. So in that condition, this corner pyramid or the corner square pyramid or the corner pentagonal pyramid or the corner hexagonal pyramid to be drawn. So here I have given the two conditions. So where the edge of base is in HP, the edge is to be kept at the right side. So where the face is in HP, the triangular face is in HP. So always note that in the pyramid, the face is being formed by joining the three points. That is the 2 points from the base and 1 point from the apex. So here, when it comes to the next three diagrams, so next three pyramids, so where I have marked it under the slant edge. So when in your question you get that the corner is in HP or VP, the corner is in HP or VP, the pentagonal pyramid has the corner is in HP, or hexagonal pyramid has the corner is in HP. So in that condition, the corner is to be kept at the right side. So whichever is to be kept at the kept on HP or VP, that is to be kept on the right side, so that it will be easy for us to tilt the solid in the third step. So these are the conditions which is involved here. So note that the pyramid will have one base and one point on the which is called as the apex and the axis as well. So OP which I have marked two in all the pyramids, I have marked it O and P, so that is the line which is passing through the center of the solid. Okay, so this is how the base to be drawn in the pyramid. So all these three are the important problems which will be involved. So that is the square pyramid, the pentagonal pyramid and the hexagonal pyramid. So when it comes to the next, prism, so here I have the same kind of diagram I've drawn here, but the only thing difference is here I don't have the slant edges. Here I have two base. I have marked the base with when it comes to the square prism here, I have marked two base. So as I've already explained, y'all, the prism will have two base. So depending upon the type, the base will be drawn. So if it is a pentagonal prism, it will have two base which is of pentagonal shape. So base will also be the pentagonal which has the five edge of base and five vertical edge as well. So here if at all the condition is been the same thing, if the edge is to be kept at the HP. So if it is said that the prism, the square prism or the hexagonal or the pentagonal, octagonal, any kind of prism it is. So if it is to be kept in the HP or VP, so what is to be kept in HP and VP, that is to be kept at the right side. That is always mandatory. So when it comes to the slant edge here, to the next diagram, so both of these are the square prism. So this is also a square prism or this is also a square prism. So which is to be chosen? So that is depend upon the question. So if at all in the question it is given that the corner is in HP or VP or the vertical edge is in HP or VP, then the second base to be drawn where the corner or the vertical edge we call it as. So here we have 2 points. So one at the bottom and one on the top, that is, so I have marked with the C bar 3. So same thing, all the points will have 2 points each. Since it is a prism, it will have two base. So one base I have marked with the letter, that is A, B, C, D, and one more base I have marked the top base, which has been marked with 1, 2, 3 and 4. So that is followed for the all the pentagon as well as the hexagon. So hexagon will also have the two base, only the shape will change, the shape of the base will change depending upon the type. So if it is a square prism, the base will be square. If it is a pentagonal prism, the base, the two base may be the bottom base and the top base. So both the base will be the pentagon. And if it is a hexagonal prism, the type, if the type is hexagonal prism, then both the base will be hexagon. So the bottom base as well as the top base. So both the base will be the hexagon. And here when I have marked at the center, the line which passes through the center of the solid, so that has been marked with OP. So I hope you all have understood where you have, which is the one to be drawn. So if the edge of base, if the edge of base is in HP or VP, the first one to be drawn. If in one more condition, if the rectangular face is in HP or VP, still the first one to be drawn. So if you look at the rectangular face here, so when it comes to the prism, here the face is being formed by joining four points. So here I have marked D4 and E5. So each line is having two points. Each point is having two points. I have marked here D4 and E5. So here in the prism, it is the rectangular face or the vertical face, which we call it as. And when it comes to the pyramid, we have the triangular face or the slant face. So thank you.